Well, I've always loved black metal music. Well, see, I study politics. I know Marxism better than a communist. I know Marxism like the back of my hand. I'll tell you about Trotskyism, Leninism, fucking National Bolshevism, forms of different social democrats, syndicalism, all forms of anarchism, all forms of conservatism, revolutionary conservatism, which is actually what predates its Nazism, National Socialism. It was actually predated by this Oswald Spengler's, who's one of my favorite authors, up there with Julius Evola, and I love those motherfuckers. They all came from the same ilk, and they were trying to describe the same thing. Oswald Spengler, I read that book. I forget the I can't remember the name of it right now, but his notorious book about history, which was ancient, which was marvelous. I know all about politics. I know all about politics. Because everything, first I got interested in, I wanted to know about psychology. I wanted to know psychology because I wanted to know how my brain works. I wanted to know more about myself so I can better control myself and so that I can self-actualize to the best of my ability, to reference Maslow. Maslow's hierarchy of needs, everyone knows that. So I wanted to learn about psychology. Learning about psychology turned into learning everything about the brain. And at the same time, learning everything about sociology. And even criminology, because I want to understand criminals. Then I wanted to understand abnormal psychology, like mental illness. But then that was not enough. I had to learn about neuroscience. I had to understand about their brains to such an intricate level. Then I had to understand about cognitive science. That wasn't enough. I still needed more. Then I needed to learn about politics, which is my new burgeoning, for the past several months now, field of study and inquiry. Sorry. Well, I had to learn about politics because I needed to learn about humans and why they do what they do en masse, because everything they do is political in nature. And politics is essentially boiled down to psychology of the masses and of societies. It's basically the study of sociology at large, if you want to look at it like that. So I had to learn about all these different... I want to learn about the communists. I want to understand, how does one gravitate towards authoritarianism, totalitarianism? I had to understand. You know, when I first started in Omnis Age back in like 2017, technically I started in 2016, but when I started in 2017, I had these ideas about capitalism, national socialism, fascism, communism, and I saw it in monarchism as well, and I saw it all as the same ism. It's all the same ism. You know, America is actually one of the luckiest countries because we actually have a democracy. We don't have most countries like Canada, for example, they have a one party dominant nation, meaning that their nation revolves around one party, which is actually what they refer to in political theory as soft despotism, soft authoritarianism. It's give the people, and that's also why during the pandemic, Canadians were so harsh and crazy, also up there with Australians. Australians were insane during the pandemic. And America is actually one of the freest nation in the world. And we have to really respect America for what it stands for, because we actually have Democrat and Republican, which is saying a lot more than most nations. Most nations of the world. America achieved the most freedom out of any country to ever live in the past 2,000 years. Go back to any historical time period, they did not have much freedom, unless you were of the wealthiest class. But America changed that. And that's something that we need to be grateful for. That is what makes this country great. We have Democrat and Republican. In my view, we should have another party. But both parties are probably actually going to change probably into one party, because now we've had this radical leftism for such a time to where sometimes when democracies get out of control, and most democracies aren't even done in the ancient Greek style the people represent themselves, but they call that an ochlocracy, ruled by the masses. The masses are never in charge.
In ancient Greek was the real form of democracy, where the masses actually were in charge. Now, modern-day democracy, they're represented. They have representatives to represent them. The masses have representatives. That didn't exist. That's not a true autocracy. We don't have ruled by the masses. But the masses still have basically ruled a lot in terms of the culture, in terms of things of that nature. Even if they didn't have even if they didn't represent themselves politically, they still represented themselves culturally, to the point where authoritarianism is the only way to solve a rundown democracy. And if there's going to be authoritarianism, maybe one party nation is the way to go. Maybe that's the only way to fix it. You have to understand these things in cycles. This is not about me saying, you know, fascism is the best form of government. It's saying that it's, at a certain point in time, these things become necessities whether you want them or not.